Center. It's only $25 to get your T-levels tested with the results back in 25 minutes. Make your health and quality of life a priority and go to lowtcenter.com to book your appointment today. That's lowtcenter.com. Low T Center, reinventing men's health care.
When it comes to bikes, here's what you want. Reliable, fast, and tough as nails. That's what you get at OCC. And after a crash, that's what you get at Rainwater, Holt, and Sexton.
Paul Sr. knows this. We're the Arkansas law firm motorcyclists have counted on for years.
We work fast to get you the best results, and we're tough where it counts, fighting for you.
Reliable, fast, tough as nails. These are the guys I'd call anywhere in the state. Dial 888-8888.
Non-lawyer spokesperson. Responsible attorneys Michael Rainwater and Bob Sexton.
There are no ordinary days in Arkansas. Hike to inspiring summits, bike on world-class trails, or fish in sparkling waters. Or see some of the world's top art collections and explore historic sites dedicated to everything from civil rights to rock and roll. After that, eat some award-winning barbecue and sip a local craft beer. So go on, get out there, and explore what the natural state has to offer. Find out more at arkansas.com.
It's the Ranger Open House Sale at Bradford Marine and ATV at all six statewide locations. Get the Ranger 520R with 250 horsepower Mercury, up to $2,000 Bass Pro gift card, and discounts up to $10,000. It's the Open House Sale at Bradford Marine and ATV, your authorized Ranger dealer.
Roger Scott here. You guys know how much I love the great outdoors. I mean, I am the naked gardener after all, and there's nothing that I love more than my very own lawn and being outside. But let's be honest, when the mosquitoes attack, it can be a real buzzkill. However, a monthly mosquito barrier from my friends at Sanders Ground Essentials can keep those skeeters away, which keeps my deck party going. Call them today at 315-9395 or on the web at sandersground.com. Sanders Ground Essentials, let's get growing.
Hey folks, Trey Johnson here with HJ Trailer Sales in Hot Springs. Spring is coming and everyone is getting ready to get outside. So if you need your trailer serviced or repaired, let us help you out. Or you may be needing a trailer to get your golf cart to the golf course. Or you need a trailer for work. Or if you just need to buy a new trailer for recreational use. Let us help you at HJ Trailer Sales with one of the best service departments in the state. Visit us in Hot Springs or check us out on Facebook or at hjtrailersales.com.
Hey, what a great show today.
It was fun. It was fantastic. And another great offering by you.
And tomorrow we'll be on the road at Edwards Food Jet, the new location in Lakewood Village.
I'm going to be so excited. I'm going to wear an apron and I'm going to start doing a bagging contest. We'll also have Craig O'Neill, RJ Hawk, and Hannah Gam.
Hand Gam, baby.
Woo!
Live from the Eat My Catfish Studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show. It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer standing by in Northwest Arkansas. I'm Randy Rainwater from the Capital City. Good afternoon, Mr. Rick Schaefer.
Well, good afternoon, Randy Rainwater. Gosh, every day's got some kind of news, doesn't it? I should tell you right off the bat, if they move last Tuesday's game to afternoon, I guess they didn't do it this week because it's not in the 30s, but it's a cool day out there. It's going to be a cold night at Baum Stadium, Baum Walker, for Arkansas and Arkansas State at 6 o'clock. Temperatures in the 40s, but at any rate, they're going to play. But that obviously is not the big news of the day.
Upper 40s, by the way.
Yes.
48 degrees.
And it's supposed to stay there all night. It's supposed to, for the whole game, it ought to be 47 or 48.
Yeah. Maybe the wind will not be a factor as well, even though I heard it was – out of the northwest at about 15 to 25 miles per hour, which is pretty typical.
It's cool.
Oh, you have other news you want to talk about, Rick?
No, you can break it if you want to. Oh. It's interesting because Kevin McPherson, who has aggravated us for the last 6 or 8 weeks with this thought that Musselman may not be there, it's probably right, because if he's going to go to interview at USC tomorrow, he needs
it's
to
It's done.
They need to, yeah.
No, it's done.
Is it? He's hired?
No, I'm just simply, I don't know that.
Well, he couldn't possibly go and come back.
Yeah. No,
he
you don't go and interview.
Right.
No.
And if you're the head coach at Arkansas and you're going to go interview, he ought to have the job before he goes.
No, it's done. Right. It's done. It's just a matter of crossing T's, dotting I's, and making sure that everyone sees from the same view, the same page, all that other stuff. So, no.
Yeah.
He does not go and interview. This is a done deal.
Yeah, that's what it's got to be.
And, in my experiences, it's a done deal. You said it when you are the head coach.
We can't come back.
Yeah, at the University of Arkansas, you don't go interview, then come back and say,
right.
No big deal. Houston, that found that out the hard way.
Yeah, well, that's right, because Houston was about to go to Nebraska and didn't. But then when his name came, here's the way it worked, and this is what Hunter Yurecek, I hope, had the conversation with Musselman. Unless you're going to USC, well, then go. You got the job. I'm going to be looking for a coach immediately. And hopefully he already has several in mind. But when Nick Saban left LSU, he made the statement when LSU was going to hire a coach, he said, the toughest coach to beat, Houston Nutt. Coach Broyles immediately called Houston and said, either go or withdraw. Because he knows what happens. When you even express interest in another job and your fan base knows it, you lose a whole lot of them. And I would say be thankful for what Eric Musselman did at Arkansas. He gave the Razorbacks basketball excellence that they have not experienced in quite some time. So nobody should be mad, upset, or anything else that he's going. But he's lost the fan base, because nobody would say, you interviewed at USC, but we still got you great.
That's you don't want to be works. Here. You're just waiting for the next.
That's exactly right.
You're just waiting for the next.
So I hope Hunter Yurecek has quite a few names in mind. And again, as I said this morning on David's show and David and Roger, there are a lot of good coaches out there. There are a lot of good coaches out there. We didn't know who Eric Musselman was.
Well, who was Nate Oates?
Here. Yeah, who
Buffalo.
Was Nate? He was at
Buffalo.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. And he wasn't even a Bill. So, you know, he and look what he's done at Alabama. So, yes, there are a lot of good coaches out there. Hunter gets an A-plus for bringing Eric Musselman. You hope that he's got in mind somebody else that's going to be as good or better.
It will all. As much as we want to avoid it, try to kick the can down the road, it will be just as important in this next hire. Because I was told when Chris Beard was hired by Ole Miss, the first thing that he insisted upon was he had a NIL program that he could use to bring in players. Now, we know what's happened at Ole Miss football. Mm-hmm. But the same thing had – I mean, if you're a successful coach, you realize that's how the game is being played today. And if you cannot get – that kind of support, then beware. And that includes getting players as much as it means getting coaches or coach. So if there is a level right now of commitment that's got to be made, it's got to be made on the NIL front. And that's pretty simple. We have got Kevin McPherson, better known as Hoop Scoop, coming up in a matter of moments. But let me try to squeeze in at least one or two phone calls before Bob, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Well, Randy, good afternoon, Rick. Good
What's
afternoon,
up?
Randy. Oh, my goodness. Well, first of all,
It happens.
I agree with Trey Beatty. He texted and said head coaches don't go and interview for jobs.
Yeah, no, they don't.
Right. And Randy, I agree with you. I believe it's a done deal. Rick, I agree with you. I'm just an agreeable person today.
Good.
I'm agreeable with Rick in the fact that when you look at where we was and what we were going through, and this man came and he built our program back, and the level of the success that he's had, I'm grateful as a fan that that he came and gave us 5 years of his life, and but that's not what I called in about. Instead of the must bus, Randy, I want to talk about the must mess. I'd like for y'all to analyze and give us your opinion as to what you think the relationship was between Hunter Yurecek and Coach Musselman. Now, the last time we heard Musk talking, he was talking about rolling up his sleeves and he was ready to get to work. He was going to start recruiting and he was anxious to do that. And I have a problem with this video, Randy, because when I first saw it, in the very last of the video, it was to me like, oh, you're still here? I'm surprised you're still here. And the podcast that, Hunter Yurecek was on, I really didn't think that it was a proper time to announce to the Razorback fans that our coach is not getting a new contract. We'd like for him to stay, but he kind of put the ball in his court. If you want to stay here, you know, it's whatever you decide to do.
I think he already knew the handwriting was on the wall.
I think so, Randy.
I think he already knew the handwriting was on the wall.
Bob, and let's stop right here. Eric Musselman still has 4 years left on his contract. So it's not like he had 1 year left and, oh, my gosh, they're not going to. He had 4 years left on his contract. I don't think anybody has brought that out until I saw it today documented.
And he did not get an extension. Who would have given an extension off
that's exactly
17
right.
and 16 yeah. or 16 and 17 season?
Yeah. Right.
But my question to you guys is this. Randy, you may have not seen the commercial. It's been several years. But there's a large investment firm in Little Rock. And it was like the younger generation that was coming up in the company and said, my dad built this company on relationships. And they were seeing way too many emails, too many texts. We're fixing to get back out there with our clients and shaking their hand and sitting down and talking with them. And my question is, why did this procedure have to happen on social media? Did they not have a good enough relationship? Hunter could just call him in and he says, you know, coach, look, there's rumors out here. You know, we're moving forward. We want this program, blah, blah, blah. Where's your level of commitment to this university?
So do you fire him? Based upon speculation?
We're guessing that didn't happen. No, you're speculating it didn't happen. It well could have happened. Could have happened during spring break. Could have happened right after spring break. You know, I made the point several times. If Musselman's going to be the coach, or even if he's not, he should have had a press conference the Monday or Tuesday after spring break, talked about how excited he was and all that kind of stuff, and then if a week later he leaves, he leaves. That happens all the time with coaches. But he never did, and to me, if the athletic director didn't ask him to do that, and he may not have even thought of it, that's used to be policy, not so many, you don't do it so much anymore, wrap up the season, but that's where... How do we know they weren't having conversations? And how do we know that Musselman didn't say right there on the spot, Hunter, you need to know I want to leave? We don't know that. We don't know any of that. And it'll be up to
one of the two of them, guys, to
say it, whether it happened.
My last thing, Randy, is what's your opinion as to what's going to happen now with recruiting? Do you think Cohen's going to decommit and go out there?
I think a lot of things. I have no idea, because Bob, nothing officially has happened yet.
Well, it's about to.
And it's about to. I understand that, but nothing officially has happened. So until it actually happens, I don't know that you'll get any immediate reaction from any player. Who knows? Maybe Layden Blocker comes back now. All of a sudden, who knows?
Some players might
actually return, but. Bottom line is, we won't know until it becomes official, and then all kinds of speculation starts happening.
That's right.
That's what I wanted you to speak to is, you know, I really had a lot of expectations for Blocker, and his brother that's coming up too, and I could see them playing at the University of Arkansas together, but I just wanted to get y'all's opinion about that. Hey, I'm going to get off here because I know there's 10,000 or more fans wanting to get on here. God bless y'all.
Thank you, Bob.
Here are all the things that we don't know anything about. Okay, well, first of all, here's what we do know
about USC. Hold on, Rick. Let's get Kevin McPherson in here, better known as Hoop Scoop.
All right.
And let's get his thoughts, because I'm sure he feels vindicated that there has been this level now of conversation that's gone on in the national media in particular on Musselman going to, quote, USC for an interview. So, Kevin, the floor is yours.
Well, Rick asked me almost roughly 2 weeks ago, Kevin, are you convinced that Eric Musselman's going to stay? And I quickly responded, no, I'm not. My reporting has been consistent for months. He's looking hard to leave. It is not about leverage. You're having a bad season. It may close some of his opportunities, but if he could get a job that he wanted, he would leave for that. It would not be about Ben trying to figure out a way to make it better where he's at.
All right, Kevin, can we back up for just 1 second? Because I've been asked this. I don't have a quality.
I thought I had the floor, Randy.
Well, no, because I want to help out those that are asking this question. What led to this? Why did Musselman, all the way back in October, supposedly start this process of, quote, looking around and inquiring about other opportunities? What led to that?
Well, guys, it's actually been longer than that. He's tried to leave every year after and beginning with his second season at Arkansas. So it's not really something new. It's new to everybody that's not connected in basketball circles, but it's not new to me. What was different this time, though, was the full court press on getting out. Some of my sources said going back to the summer, putting out the feelers of jobs that might open.
But why?
Or likely to open. Well, I mean, it's something he's done every year. It means that he's looking for other opportunities.
He's not unhappy with this, or he's not unhappy with that. He wasn't getting pressure from this.
A guy that is a rolling stone, Randy. I mean, he's got his own reasons. He's not stayed anywhere for very long. I don't think it's specific.
5 years is the max.
There are some things specific to Arkansas. I won't go into those just here today because I want to talk about this process of where we're at now. I've got a source that is connected to one of the most well-known and respected college basketball coaching representative agencies, just represents coaches, telling me that this job's already been offered to Musselman at USC, and effectively this interview trip tomorrow is you know, dot well, nines across the T's, working out details, and it's a coronation.
He has to go. He has to. He can't come back.
So, but the Hunter Yurecek stuff affirms what I've been saying for a while. I've been consistent on my messaging that if he gets an opportunity that he likes, he's going, and he's been looking for a long time. And I understand that there were going to be people that didn't understand that, didn't like hearing it, and even there would be efforts made to discredit what I put out. And I told you guys during segments, there will be a push to discredit this stuff until they have to acknowledge it, or if they can make it work out with Musk, they'll never want it to come out to see daylight. But that's exactly what happened. And so, you know, I'm not trying to sit here and gloat or anything like that, but, Rick, you were pretty adamant that what you were getting is he's not going anywhere.
I was talking to
you. And you gave me a little bit of a lecture about how I was reporting things, but I was solid like I always am.
Well,
I was solid like I always am, and I stuck to it.
And I will give you credit for that, but I wouldn't change a thing that I said because
– No, listen, you only know what you know, Rick. You only know what you know, and I understand that.
That's
you
right.
only know what you know, and I understand that.
And I would say the same for you, Mr. Kevin. And so
I respect the hell out of you guys. Don't take this the wrong way.
But let me just say this. This was handled poorly by everybody. And if Musselman had been looking for jobs, and I'll say this, and you know how I love Hunter Yurecek, handled poorly by him. And when the SEC tournament was over, they should have had a meeting, and maybe they did. And maybe it led to this, but maybe they did. And he should have said, Eric, you either need to get in front of people and say you're staying or you need to go. And maybe that's what started all this. I don't know.
I'll go you one further, Rick, and you guys can believe what you want to believe. I don't think they want to hold – I don't think Hunter Yurecek or anybody up there that's dealt with this guy for a while wants to do anything but hold the door open and help him out.
I have heard that, and I'm not going to get into that, but I have heard that
we don't have to get into it, but I've put it out there.
He's been definitely difficult to deal with.
I stand by that 100% as well.
No, I think you're right on that, and I had somebody very close to me and very close to that basketball situation say that if he ever wins big, he will be impossible to deal with. So I think you're right there. At any rate,
you know, this is not.
Who's the next coach? Yeah. All right. You obviously, I'll give you credit. You know a lot more than we do. So who's the next coach?
Well, I'm told Hunter has a plan. He may even have a coach and staff in waiting. I mean, I have a source who has given me good information before that claims that. We'll see. Sometimes we think that, and it hasn't worked out that way, right? In previous hires, and so. I don't fully buy into that, but I do think it's a strong possibility. And look, I think some of the names that are out there that you're going to see on a short list are Chris Beard, Jerome Tang, Will Wade. There's some other names I'm told. But I think Hunter Yurecek has known for a while that Eric Musselman, if I've known it, he's known it. I'm not trying to claim I've known something that Yurecek hasn't, but that most haven't. But I think he's been efforting to get his ducks in a row, and there was never going to be a play to extend Musselman or offer anything like that. I don't think Musselman cared about that anyway. I think he's been efforting what I've been reporting, been efforting to get out for a long time. And at some point, I'm going to tell you the schools and places he wanted to get, starting with year two. He wanted the Alabama job that Nate Oates got. He was upset about that. There's a nugget for you. Wore out his assistants talking about it.
Wow.
There's one.
Don't go away.
I'm sorry. I thought you said, here's one. I thought that's what you said, here's one.
Yeah, I thought you were going to say another one.
Okay.
Well, here's a nugget. Here's a little nugget of information I'm sharing with you. You asked me earlier in the segment, Randy, what's been going on up there? Why does he want to leave so bad? And I could drop stuff all day. Write a book or two.
All right, let's talk with Savage. Savage, good afternoon. You got a question or comment for Kevin?
Yes, sir. You know, Kevin, don't take this wrong. I'm not trying to be rude, but you say that you have sources, but then when Rick and Randy ask you any other question about sources, you say that I can't talk about it, but then when it reveals itself 2 weeks later, you take pride in saying, yeah, I stuck to my guns and I know about it. If I have a source, just me first, if I have a source and I say, Randy and Rick, I've got a source that told me this, and I go ahead and blurt out what I heard. I don't say I have a source, but guys, I can't talk about it. Don't ask me about it. I can't talk about it. Why even bring it up? That's just my opinion. And why don't we go out there and get the NC State coach? If he's hot and upcoming, let's go get this guy from NC State and let Musk go to USC, be with his mom, and go on. Guys, have a good one.
Well, if you get him, is DJ Burns have any eligibility left? If you get him, can you get Burns with him?
I want to address this guy straight on because he's got it wrong. I've protected my sources and not giving more specifics. I don't know how clear I could have been that this guy's looking to leave and will leave if the opportunity comes up. I acknowledge I'm not sure how that will play out for him and which job it will be. I'm not coming back today and say, well, I told you he was going to leave the USC. That's not what I'm saying. I've been talking about process, not the end result. Process. He's looking hard to leave. There's no doubt about it in my mind based on my source information. Just because I can't tell you who the source is that said it doesn't mean that I'm, you know, playing trickery with it. I'm telling you what the message is. Then I was asked, well, what do you think? You think he'll be back? I don't know, guys. I'm kind of on the fence. Maybe a slight lean that he won't be because he's trying so hard. But he's also got some baggage. Part of that's a losing season. Part of it's off the court stuff. Some of it was coaching firm stuff that I didn't specifically bring up, but that was part of what it was. And it did cost him opportunities that he wanted when he talked Louisville and maybe a couple other ones. So Savage has got it wrong. I'm not sitting here saying, well, I told you he was headed to USC, and I knew that. I'm not saying that. That was one of the jobs he wanted, and it looks like it's one that he's going to get.
All right, Kevin. Thank you. That is Kevin McPherson, better known as Hoop Scoop, courtesy of Hogville.net. Coming up next, Kevin Bohannon. Thanks to our good friends at the Wood Family Dealerships in Batesville. Stay tuned.
Chickens of Central Arkansas presents Rolling with Nolan on Drive Time Sports with Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer every Thursday at 6 on 103.7 The Buzz.
Hi, folks. It's Chris Zender here at Frank Fletcher Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sherwood. When you're in the market for a new Dodge Chrysler Jeep or Ram, we hope you give us a chance to earn your business. Here's some things to consider. Fletcher Dodge has been family-owned dealer here in Sherwood for over 25 years. We know how to take care of our customers to keep them coming back. Every Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram dealer pays the same price for their vehicles. It's the dealer that makes the difference. We'll give you the best deal up front. No haggling, no arguing. We make it easy to buy a new vehicle, and we'll pay you more for your trade-in. Compare our deal to anybody's, and you'll buy from us. Come see us today for the deal of a lifetime on new Dodge Chrysler Jeep or Ram. At Frank Fletcher Dodge, you always get the best price, the lowest finance rate, and more for your trade. And we promise you a hassle-free buying experience. We want to be your dealer for life. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Just tell us what you're looking for and we'll make you a deal. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood or shop online at FletcherDeals.com.
Right now at Fort Thompson, Smith & Wesson Shield 2.09 mm, $269.90. Beretta APX-A1, 9mm, $199.90 after $50 mail-in rebate. CCI 9mm brass, 50 count box, $12.99 at Fort Thompson in Sherwood.
This is Pat Bradley for Whit Davis. Do you feel a draft around your windows? Does condensation constantly build up? What about high energy bills? It may be time for you to reach out to my good friends over at Whit Davis. Not only do they sell replacement windows, but they can also refer to you to a host of professionals who'll measure and install them for you. New windows can improve your home's energy efficiency while boosting your curb appeal. So what are you waiting for? Give Whit Davis a call. And remember, Whit Davis Lumber Plus is more than just a lumberyard. It's Pat Bradley for Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, where their customers are always number one. Speaking about numbers, 6% APY is still available at Alcoa. Earn up to 6% interest on your checking account balances for doing the things you already do, like using your debit card and direct deposit. You can also get your ATM fees waived. Apply today for your free Kasasa checking account and earn up to 6% APY at AlcoaCommunityFCU.org. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, serving Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry Counties.
Hi, I'm Rick Pennington of Lion's Drug. We have great news. Generic Cialis is now available at a huge savings. We have Tadalafil, the FDA-approved generic of Cialis, in a 20-milligram tablet at a savings of up to 80%. We have the 5-milligram daily tablets for less than $3 a pill. Lion's Drug continues to be your go-to pharmacy for men's health. What are you waiting for? Call us today at 844-676-2222. Or go to our website at lionsdrug.com.
At Kubota, we want to help you deliver a job done right. That's why we want you to know that new Kubota inventory is arriving daily. You have work to do? We have the reliable, durable, and versatile lineup to help you do it. Visit River Valley Tractor today for all your equipment needs. Visit your local River Valley Tractor dealer. www.rivervalleytractor.com.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports, live from the Eat My Catfish Studios, where it's much like any of the 7 Eat My Catfish locations, minus the always fresh, delicious food options like the family pack catfish dinners.
Often imitated but never duplicated, this is Drive Time Sports with Randy Rainwater on the Buzz Radio Network.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports. You're on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer. I'm Randy Rainwater. Want to talk to you about Double B's. New month, new specials. And as I gaze over some of the specials, I always love to check first for any of the drink specials, obviously, because you got the 20-ounce Coke for just $1.17, or the 28-ounce Gatorade for just $5. And then you have that great special they started last month, the 12-ounce 7-Up glass bottles, $3. They carried that one forward. And then they have the great Frito-Lay specials, which they are always fantastic opportunities, too, for $4. And I was speaking of the 20-ounce Coke. That includes Diet Coke and Coke Zero for just $1.17. So a lot of great specials you'll find at your local Double B's. You can always start off your day with that Renoco cup of coffee or that Renoco cappuccino, because it all starts at Double B's, where you gas it, grab it, and go. Make it Double B's.
Baseball season is in full swing, and you don't want to miss a thing. It's time for Around the Horn with Kevin Bohannon. Around the Horn is brought to you by Stanley Wood, Buick, Chevy, GMC, and Scott Wood, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram. And now, it's time for Around the Horn.
Rick, I must tell you, Kevin sent me the itinerary for today's show.
Yeah.
And at the end of his comment, at the end of it, he says, let me find that. There it is. Says, and no basketball talk. Then he's got the tears coming from the eyes of the emoji or whatever it's called. And I'm thinking, okay, Kevin, do you really not want to come on today?
Well, if we have callers, that's probably going to be what we're going to talk about.
Yeah. Oh, we have callers.
Number one ranked baseball team in America. Yep. Mm-hmm. For 4 weeks straight now.
Yep.
Can we enjoy some of the things that Arkansas fans have been yearning for the last 9 months? Can we just enjoy it and move forward with it?
No. Yes. No, that's not Arkansas.
Yeah. No. Yes, we can enjoy that. At the same time, we can talk about the biggest story there is, because the team has been ranked number one for 4 weeks. Yesterday, we talked about beating LSU. Tomorrow we can talk about beating Mississippi, but right now the big news is the basketball coach is leaving.
I agree, and that's y'all's job. He is leaving?
Is leaving, yes.
Okay. I just saw where he was interviewing, so.
Hey, you don't look, when you're the head coach at Arkansas, you don't interview for a job. You go out to accept it.
I get it, yeah.
He'll be named on the spot. They'll announce him. And here's the other thing is, USC's best recruit, the number one player in California, McDonald's All-America, point guard, decommitted today because the coach left to go to SMU. They want Musselman to get in there and get him back.
Right. So I'll take this opportunity to apologize to Kevin McPherson.
You've been reading the live fan feedback, huh?
No, I haven't. I mean, Kevin's got a hard job, and he does a good job with his area of expertise. Getting into the grassroots basketball level and covering it the way he does, it's the same thing I do with baseball, so I know the work that he puts in. You know, some things I may not agree with how he releases information, but, if this comes to fruition, spot on, you know?
He's connected. There's no doubt he's more connected than we are. But here's the only thing I would have argued with, and I didn't know he was going to leave so soon, or I would have said it on the air. As Savage called and challenged him, the same thing I would say is, look, all it takes is saying, guys, don't ask me why. I'm just getting the sense that Eric Musselman's trying to leave.
Right.
He doesn't have to say, and I've talked to this person and talked to that person. All you have to do is say, don't be surprised if Eric Musselman is not the coach next year. And I really don't have any solid evidence on that, but that's kind of what I'm thinking. That's all.
Yeah. All right.
And then you prove yourself right, and that's fine.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going back to your original notes here.
All right. 23-3.
Oh, wait a minute. Billy, hold on from our Buzz text line. Will Kevin apologize to McPherson? He just did it.
There you go. Yeah.
He just did it. Okay, Wally says from our live fan feedback, please tell Rick to apologize to Kevin McPherson. Basically gave your show the scoop that Mus was looking to leave and mocked him and questioned his integrity. You'll lose listeners if Rick doesn't do that. Probably wouldn't hurt you for Kevin Bohannon to do the same thing as he backhandedly.
And I'm getting... I never called out Kevin. personally or anything. I want to make that known.
We didn't either. We didn't either, but we questioned what he was saying without giving evidence, and I think that's okay. Yeah. And if somebody wants to fault me for that, I'm sorry you feel that way. I'm not right all the time. I certainly wasn't right on this. I talked to somebody that lives in his neighborhood that absolutely couldn't believe there was any thought that he was leaving.
Well,
okay?
that's
not the coach at USC, but that's who I talked to.
Here is my other issue. If you're going to throw out he's been trying to leave Arkansas beginning with year number two, then what are the reasons? What are the reasons? I don't think you start throwing that out there.
He may not know that. And that's the thing is, as people were asking me why would he leave, to me there were only two reasons, and one of which was he can't stay anywhere very long. And again, you look at Arkansas's 5 years, and then he was at his first job in the CBA 5 years. He's never been anywhere longer than that. And so
maybe that's
and there are people like that, particularly high achievers sometimes, that just feel like they've got to keep moving on. Okay, so look what he did at Arkansas. He got him to the Elite Eight twice, Sweet 16. He may be thinking in his mind, that's as far as I can go here. But if I go somewhere else, USC was 15-18 last year. So he's not walking into a program that's been winning. And he may think, if I go there, first year
in
the NCAA, I'm a hero again.
They've really never won at a high level. They had O.J. Mayo back in 04. You know, that Arkansas played them that year, I believe. Back, 06, 07.
Because then Arkansas packing in the NCAA tournament. Didn't that lead to the dismissal of Stan Heath?
It was Stan Heath's last game.
Yeah.
So back then, and they've really never been good. So, maybe that's the thing. So.
And he loves California. So
that's true. He's been Sacramento. So he's been out there.
He's not. I don't think LA. How far is it? 100, 125 miles from San Diego. That's where his mother lives.
Yeah.
If he wants to be closer to his mother, I love that. That's great. All right. So again, this from the 501 from our Buzz text line. You guys are falling all over yourselves. Backtracking how you spoke to and treated McPherson.
Look, if people think we treated him poorly, I'm sorry. And if you want to quit listening to us because you thought we treated him poorly, I'm sorry. I hope that won't be the case. I hope we're still interesting. And I still will stand by what I say, the way it could have been handled. And Kevin obviously can disagree with us, and he's more than welcome to do that. And it doesn't mean we dislike each other. And here's the other thing in today's society. If we disagree with each other, it doesn't mean we dislike each other. Kevin is a good guy.
Yeah, you can have debates. Have debates and civilized conversations. Mike Irwin and I had a conversation on Twitter, a debate the other day, about the same exact topic. So it's not like we're throwing somebody under the bus or anything. We're debating, you know, the way somebody did their job. They do it to me every day. That's the business that we got in. You can have disagreements without really saying you really dislike somebody or you can't stand somebody. That's the problem today. Is if you disagree with somebody, you're outcast all of a sudden. So that's not where we're going at right now. We had a differing opinion on how something should have been handled, and we're moving forward with it. That's it. Nobody's backtracking.
Okay, from our bus text line, is there a baseball game tonight? This from the 501.
Yes.
Who is number one in high school baseball? And what time is the baseball game?
I'll start with right now. 6 o'clock, yes. And who is number one in high school baseball? Well, six different classifications. Yeah, Taylor's number one in 1A. Woodlawn's number one in 2A. Harding Academy's number one in 3A. Lone Oak number one in 4A. Valley View number one in 5A. And as of right now, Rogers is number one in class 6A.
Okay, this from Kenneth by way of our live in feedback. Can you talk about Brady Tigert? Do you think the staff has any concerns about his last few outings or making a change and moving him back to the bullpen?
Yes, I think there is some question of, and I've questioned this since Brady was in high school. He's been injury prone. He's gone through some issues. He was down last year. And now I want to preface this. This is not a knock on Brady. I love Brady Tiger. He's played for the Prospects organization at some point. So this is not me belittling or demeaning Brady. I want to say that right now. I think Brady is better out of the bullpen, bar none. His fastball is only 90 to 92 right now. He can't command his fastball very well right now. His strike to walkout ratio is the lowest on the team. He struck out, 42 and walked 16. So he struck out 3 the other day in 4 innings of work. That was his shortest outing of the year. Now, out of the bullpen, he can work 93, 95, throw that hammer curveball. It gives teams a different look out of the bullpen. Now, who would you slide into that starting spot? Could it be a Ben Bibee or a Colin Fisher? We don't know. We're not at that point yet. But I think there are some issues right now, and if he can work through it, great. He went 6 against Oklahoma State, but that was a month and a half ago, or a little over 5 weeks ago. He's got to be more consistent with his fastball and pitch off of that. He can't pitch backwards enough going through a lineup 2-plus times. It just won't work in the SEC. But there's nothing really I think the coaching staff needs to panic about because they are so deep. And that was one of the things I told you earlier, Randy, is that we knew the pitching staff was going to be deep, and we've heard that the last 2 years. I think it's deeper than any of us ever thought because there are guys that aren't getting to pitch right now that could possibly be opening or weekend starters with mid-major Power 5 teams across the nation.
They'll hang around. They may be next year at Arkansas. That's the key.
That's
you
the
problem. Yeah.
So when you can roll Christian Fauci out there and he lights it up like he did the other night at 99 and gets out of a bases loaded jam, only giving up 1 run, the momentum went to Arkansas's favor after that. So Dylan Carter is going to get the pitch. Cooper Dossett, Gage Wood,
Ben Bibee.
Yeah. This is a loaded staff.
Yeah. In fact, you're talking about that replacement for Tiger in the rotation. Ben Bibee could be a great option. Maybe even Colin Fisher, for that matter. All right, we'll step aside for a moment. Drive Time Sports will continue in just one moment.
Clint Sterner here for Low T Center. Fellas, if you've been feeling tired and grumpy, maybe you've noticed a lack of motivation and drive, a little weight gain, loss of muscle mass. These could all be signs of low testosterone levels. It happens. It's not if, it's when. The key, fellas, is that you address the issue. At Low T Center, it's easy to get your levels checked. We're talking a simple blood test with results back in about 25 minutes. Low T Center, it's not your typical doctor's office, no sir. It's concierge medicine for all of us men. They're physicians. They specialize in treating low testosterone with customized treatments for each patient. Most health insurance is accepted for treatment, and they have affordable and convenient treatment options, including physician-monitored self-inject treatments for established patients. Those treatments, they ship directly to your home each and every month, so there's no need to drive to the center for weekly visits. Right now, Low T Center, it's only $25 to get your T levels tested with the results back in 25 minutes. Make your health and quality of life a priority and go to lowtcenter.com to book your appointment today. That's lowtcenter.com. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
Stanley Wood Chevrolet Buick GMC wants to make sure you're getting the service you deserve and your vehicle needs. Choices in sales, service, fair prices, and relationships built on trust is the Wood family promise, and we stand by it. When you purchase a new vehicle from us, the first oil change and inspection is free. Come see us today and experience the Wood family promise. Stanley Wood Chevrolet Buick GMC in Batesville, just south of the airport, online at stanleywoodchevrolet.com. We are professional grade.
This is the Pigskin Preacher, bringing you the word. Few entertainers are as interesting and enigmatic as Andre 3000. The former rapper from Outkast was responsible for the wildly catchy Hey Ya in 2003. He also starred in Will Ferrell's Semi-Pro as the Flint Tropics basketball star Sugar Dunkerton and Coffee Black. These days, he is pursuing a solo career in experimental music, on which he plays a variety of flutes. Andre remains a radical chameleon of music and style, getting his ideas across even without using words. If Andre 3000 came to Arkansas, he would come to Doubleby's for some delicious bean-to-cup Rinoco coffee, any way he wants it. Coffee black, with cream, cappuccino, or whatever he would choose. And whatever you would choose. Doubleby's. It's where you gas it, grab it, and go. That's Doubleby's.
What do you do when the power goes out? Well, now you can do anything you want when you purchase a Generac home standby generator from Generator Supercenter of Little Rock. Come visit the experts at Central Arkansas' only generator showroom located on Chenal Parkway in West Little Rock. We offer a turnkey solution, financing, and 24/7 service. Visit our website for more info at GeneratorSupercenterOfLittleRock.com. The standby power people.
Live from the Eat My Catfish studios, you feed your crave for sports by listening to Drive Time Sports. Much like you feed your crave at any of the 7 Eat My Catfish locations. You're safe at home with Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports here on the Buzz Radio Network. For those that may be asking, for what it's worth, we do have a baseball game tonight, Arkansas State. Some may be happy, some may not be happy, but we will be off at 5:30 for the pregame show with the first pitch scheduled around 6:02 tonight. So, yes, baseball tonight, Arkansas State. We are now joined by Neil Atkinson by way of Bet Saracen. I don't think you had this on the Bet Saracen site. At least I couldn't find it. Is Eric Musselman going to USC, yes or no? And any kind of percentages that was on that. So I think it looks like it's
coming. Yeah, we're probably not going to spread that one because you never know when what time of the day the announcement would be made or if there's a leak or what's happening what. And we usually do that on a lot of trade. We do that on, you know, players being traded and things like that. We can't put that up because just too much can happen and there's too many leaks out there in the media and the sports media and things of that nature. So,
well, you did respond. Now, I got to say, Bet Saracen did respond last night to the request for some Caitlin Clark prop specials, and I think she kind of blew them all away, did she not?
Yes, she did, and we're already working to have some for the women's Final Four involving all of that too. So it's going to be an exciting weekend coming up with the Final Four. I know a lot of us are disappointed, especially in our brackets. I know as a Tennessee fan, you know, I hated to see what happened against Purdue. Kind of saw it coming with that big player. But anyway, hey, my bracket was in the trash before, I think, last Thursday. So not too big on me. Now, we do have a line on the Arkansas game tonight. I may put a run line on it here in the next 10 minutes. Last I looked, we're the only book in the country that has a line. Arkansas is minus 3,000. Very, very heavily favorites. Arkansas State is plus 1,000. You know, sometimes these middle of the week games are a little bit different than the conference series games.
UCA pulled off an upset today down in Starkville.
Absolutely. So it is possible. I am going to possibly put up a run line here in the next 10 or 15 minutes. But as always, we always supplement with the double R prop. So you've got those up there. You've got a bunch of selections and choices up there that you won't have and don't have on any other book in the country. But Bet Saracen, because we're going to cover what we can with the local sports.
I like it. I like it. And I would guess the over-under would be somewhere around, what, 8, 9.5 runs in today's game?
Maybe there. I'm actually running the last-minute modeling on it and going to try to put a line up. My risk guys don't want me to have that line up any more than an hour before the game starts because it is a non-conference matchup. And you look at the records, and Arkansas is only the number one team in the nation coming off a big sweep of last year's national champion, LSU.
That's right.
And your team's doing good. They win, but your odds are not always as good when you're playing number one. Sort of like UConn is a heavy favorite to win the national championship right now. So, you know, you got to roll with the punches. When your team's good, you don't always get the best prices on them.
And when will the odds be out for this weekend for the Final Four?
Oh, they're already up. They were up about 30 minutes after the games were set. So, Purdue is favored by – yeah, you got Purdue favored by 9.5 over NC State Wolfpack. That's a 1-11 seed. And then you got the UConn Huskies versus Alabama, Crimson Tide. Who's the bigger favorite? The UConn Husky. They are a double-digit favorite against Alabama, 11.5. Who would thought the final four games would be basically 10-point spread?
Wow.
When you got to this level. But when you look at Purdue and UConn, that's what the numbers are saying.
Okay, sure as I click on the basketball, now they pop up. All right, where can we find all this good stuff, Neil?
On the web, go to betsaracen.com, or better yet, from your phone, go to the Apple Apple Store or the Google Play Store and just search Bet Saracen. You'll be able to click on us, download, in less than 5 minutes you can register, fund your account, and be betting on your favorite player or team.
There you go. Thank you, Neil. BetSaracen.com. Better yet, go get the app in the App Store at BetSaracen. All right, Kevin, I don't want to run you short of time, which I already have, but where do we want to turn to next? I want to make sure you get your minutes worth.
Let's talk about Arkansas this weekend against Ole Miss.
Okay.
How about that?
Okay, let's do that.
Okay. So, Arkansas, of course, and they had 12 guys start this past weekend on offense. And that's one of the things that Coach Van Horn talked about in the Swatters Club meeting yesterday was these guys are always ready to play. Peyton Holt's going to get some time tonight against Arkansas State. Jack Wagner got a start last week against Little Rock, played well, and then got to start as DH against LSU this past weekend. Nolan Sousa got some time in there. So, Coach Van Horn continues to go with matchups. Ross Lovich, Will Edmondson got the gorilla mask the other day after a 3-for-3 performance. So these guys stay engaged. They're a team. There's no whoa, whoa is me. There's some guys like Jason Jones that wish I could get out there and play. I showed some flashes earlier in the year and hit 3 home runs, but haven't seen the field since. Ryder Helfrich got in the game against Auburn, hit a home run in the top of the 9th inning. He was rewarded with a start midweek and then a start in the series against LSU. So these guys continue to play and play as a team, and I think that's what's going to take them as far as they want to go this season. Now, look at Ole Miss. Ole Miss is 18-11 on the season. They're 3-6 in the SEC. They were swept last weekend by a very good Kentucky team, a very veteran Kentucky team. All right, Ole Miss has struggled at Arkansas, of course. A couple of years ago when they came up there, I was up there for the series. Arkansas won 2 out of 3. They lost on Friday. And then one Saturday, Sunday. They've got one pitcher that would qualify for an ERA title right now. That's Riley Maddux. He's had 31 innings pitched. Everybody else is really kind of up and down this year. Their other starters, Gunnar Dennis, 8.68 ERA. Liam Doyle, 6.04 ERA. Their 5.62 ERA as a team. They've only struck out, they're pretty good strikeout. They've struck out 293 as a staff. But their team has struck out 210 times as a team. That should bode very well for the Arkansas pitching staff, who last Thursday against LSU struck out 19 against one of the top offenses in America. So one thing I saw the other day, Arkansas's offense, they've struck out 179 times. They've either been walked or hit by a pitch 179 times. That's a 1-to-1 ratio. You don't see that every day. They're leading the league in least strikeouts. They're leading the league in so many different categories right now that translate into championship teams. And that's one of the things that bodes very well for this weekend. Will they get a sweep? It's hard to do. 3 out of 4 sweeps to start the year, but there's a good chance they can do it this weekend.
All right, let's squeeze in Pete. Nope. Yeah. Let's talk to Stan. Stan, good afternoon.
How you doing, Randy?
What up, Stan?
Stan, you were right. Eric Musselman will not win a national championship at Arkansas.
That why he leave? He already realized that. Come on, man. You realize he ain't never win on that championship.
He must have heard you. He must have heard you.
Yeah, he ain't going to win that at Arkansas. He realized that. Man, smart. He's a smart man. Now, Randy, do that tickle you? Randy had to laugh.
I can sleep good tonight, Stan, knowing that what you've been telling us all this time,
hey man, you know what I need
is coming to pass.
You know what I need to be. Hey, y'all know what I make? I'd make a good sports writer, wouldn't I?
Oh, man.
Man,
you would drive off more fans than anything. But that's okay.
But Stan, you write the same column every time.
Because I don't know what he'd be thinking. I don't know what's wrong.
What would you talk about, though, after you wrote it for one time? In my opinion, you're going to look at me funny, readers, but I'm going to tell you, you're looking at me funny. Maybe you're looking at my picture, but I'm going to tell you, he's not going to win a national championship here. In fact, I heard you today talking about Dave Van Horn. He's not going to win a national championship. How do you know that? I mean, I'd go with the entire field before I'd go with Dave Van Horn.
Hey, Randy. A lot of people gonna look at me. A lot of people gonna look at me.
Oh, they do already, Stan.
A lot of them ain't gonna like this, huh?
They do already, Stan.
A lot of them ain't gonna like this, Dan.
But they can't ever see you. They don't know where to look for you.
Hey. A lot of them ain't gonna like this. Hey, Rick.
What?
Rick. A lot of them ain't gonna like this.
What?
Hey, a lot of them gonna like this. Dan Van Horn ain't gonna win, Andy.
Wow, that's the first time you've said that.
Yeah, Dan Van Horn ain't gonna win on that championship. They number one. That
Killing
don't mean nothing. Hey, Rick. They pick a dude soon. They not gonna win on that championship.
They're not gonna win one. I'm going with the entire field.
Hey, look here, Stan.
Wesson revolvers are built to suit the demands of the most serious firearms enthusiast. And for a limited time at Max Prairie Wings in Stuttgart, receive a $50 rebate on Smith & Wesson J-frame revolvers or a $75 rebate on Smith & Wesson K-frame, L-frame, N-frame, and Governor revolvers. This offer expires April 30th, so hurry before time runs out. Max Prairie Wings, with the best selection, the most competitive prices, and all the ammo you need. So make the short drive to Stuttgart today or online at maxpw.com.
Roger Scott for Gravely Mowers. You know, when it comes to beautiful lawns, nothing cuts like a Gravely. And when it comes to cutting prices, there's nothing like the Gravely Mow the Distance sales event, where you can save up to 25%. And special financing is available on America's most rugged and dependable mowers, including their ZT-HD. It's the residential mower built to commercial standards. But hurry, because the Mow the Distance sale is only through April 8th and only at your authorized Gravely dealers like Chapel Hardware in Pine Bluff or Hoco Turf in Roland.
Mark your calendars for the 20th annual Double B's BuzzBecue, Saturday, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Tickets on sale soon.
103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock, powered by you, the fan.
Fire it up! I'm listening!
Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
Voters across Arkansas return to the polls today to decide the outcome of several runoff elections. They include the Pine Bluff mayor race, state house runoffs for Democrats in districts 35 and 63, and a Republican runoff in District 88, and a Pulaski County Justice of the Peace race. Anyone who casts a ballot in the primary for one of those House seats can vote today, but they must vote in the same party primary. Governor Sanders announced the expansion of her school voucher program in Arkansas. The eligibility pool for vouchers has expanded to include children of veterans, military reserve members, first responders, and law enforcement officers. Also, students from D-rated schools join those in F-rated or level 5 districts in being able to apply. More than 5,400 families applied for what they call education freedom accounts during the last school year. Starting 1 year from now, all Arkansas students will be eligible for that assistance. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
If you don't already have the Bet Saracen Sports Wager app, download it today from the app stores or go to BetSaracen.com. Bet Saracen is Arkansas's favorite sports betting app.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Still warm and windy today. Behind a few morning showers, we'll see clearing skies and a high of 75. Cooler tonight as we drop to 44. Sunshine back for Wednesday and Thursday with highs in the 60s. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Fence Brokers presents Razorback Graffiti every Monday morning. Call Morning Mayhem and let them know how you feel about how they did. One sentence and one sentence only.
Save the date for the Luxury Pool & Spa annual sale the week of April 15th at their Conway and Russellville locations. 20% off store-wide, including patio furniture by Fisco, spas at truckload pricing, and rebates on pool chemicals, plus over $12,000 in giveaways during the annual Luxury Pool & Spa sale the week of April 15th.
This is Pat Bradley for Whit Davis. Do you feel a draft around your windows? Does condensation constantly build up? What about high energy bills? It may be time for you to reach out to my good friends over at Whit Davis. Not only do they sell replacement windows, but they can also refer to you to a host of professionals who measure and install them for you. New windows can improve your home's energy efficiency while boosting your curb appeal. So what are you waiting for? Give Whit Davis a call. And remember, Whit Davis Lumber Plus is more than just a lumberyard.
Hello, folks. It's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge store here in Sherwood. For the past few months, we've been asking you to give us a chance to buy your cars, and the response has been great. We really appreciate all of you who brought your cars in and turned it into cash. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Folks, we're still buying cars every day. So look around and see what you or your family has in the garage that you want to turn into cash. It's really easy, folks. Just come into Fletcher Dodge and ask for Chris or Andy. We'll buy any vehicle and we'll pay you more than anyone. We can't find enough vehicles at the auto auctions to meet the demand, so we're extending you this offer to the public. We'll pay you more, so don't wait. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Come see us today for the best cash offer on your car, truck, van, or SUV. Just ask for Chris or Andy. We'll pay you more, so come see us at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood. Thanks.
It's Justin Akre for CertaPro Painters, and if you're like me, this time of the year I'm spending a lot of time at the house watching basketball games and baseball games, and then I also start looking around the house and noticing some paint on the wall might have cracked, or you might see some scuffs on the wall, and you want to get that updated. If that's the case at your house, you need to get CertaPro Painters on the case today. CertaPro.com, that's Certa with a C. All you have to do is go to their website, and they will come over, give you a free estimate, and you can trust them to get the job done right, because they take pride in what they do. Each CertaPro Painters business is independently owned and operated. When it comes to choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose CertaPro Painters.
It's Pat Bradley for Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, where their customers are always number one. Speaking about numbers, 6% APY is still available at Alcoa. Earn up to 6% interest on your checking account balances for doing the things you already do, like using your debit card and direct deposit. You can also get your ATM fees waived. Apply today for your free Kasasa checking account and earn up to 6% APY at alcoacommunityfcu.org. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union. Serving Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties.
You can hear the best of the NCAA tournament on 106.7 Buzz 2, from the very beginning all the way to the championship game. March Madness on 103.7 The Buzz and 106.7 Buzz 2.
Clint Sterner here for Low T Center. Fellas, if you've been feeling tired and grumpy, maybe you've noticed a lack of motivation and drive, a little weight gain, loss of muscle mass. These could all be signs of low testosterone levels. It happens. It's not if, it's when. The key, fellas, is that you address the issue. At Low T Center, it's easy to get your levels checked. We're talking a simple blood test with results back in about 25 minutes. Low T Center, it's not your typical doctor's office, no sir. It's concierge medicine for all of us men. They're physicians. They specialize in treating low testosterone with customized treatments for each patient. Most health insurance is accepted for treatment, and they have affordable and convenient treatment options, including physician-monitored self-inject treatments for established patients. Those treatments, they ship directly to your home each and every month, so there's no need to drive to the center for weekly visits. Right now, Low T Center, it's only $25 to get your T levels tested with the results back in 25 minutes. Make your health and quality of life a priority and go to lowtcenter.com to book your appointment today. That's lowtcenter.com. Low T Center, reinventing men's health care.
I love it here in Arkansas. It's a great place to live and work, to raise a family. Got beautiful scenery, tons to do outdoors, and we love our sports. Arkansas is just a great place. It's one of the things I like most about First Security Bank. They started years ago right here in Arkansas. After 80 years of growth, First Security is still only in Arkansas. That means we invest in people and businesses right here at home. They have local roots, and they're proud of them. I don't know about you, but that means something to me. At First Security, you bank with professionals who know what they're doing. They also know you and your community. So whether you need a personal or business checking account, a credit card, help with a loan, or just want to ask someone a question, First Security is your home for friendly local support. Stop by one of their 70 convenient locations or check them out online at fsbank.com. First Security Bank, only in Arkansas. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Live from the Eat My Catfish studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show. It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Hour number two of Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer standing by in Northwest Arkansas. I'm Randy Rainwater from the Capital City. We'll be joined by Trey Biddy of hogsports.com, being brought to you by Chris Crane Hyundai and Genesis of Conway. If you want to purchase a new Chevy Trailblazer, Guatney Chevrolet is the place to go. They are Arkansas's largest dealer of Chevy Trax and Trailblazer SUVs. Guatney has the sleek black 2024 Chevrolet Trailblazer LT available on the lot in Jacksonville. It can be yours for as low as $24,490. Hurry to Guatney Chevrolet in Jacksonville at 1301 T.P. Watt Drive, better known as the Gregory Street exit, exit 167-67 in the heart of downtown Jacksonville. Look for that big American flag for a fantastic deal on the feature-filled Chevrolet Trailblazer compact SUV and start blazing your own trail. Chevrolet, together, let's drive.
And now, Trey Biddy is brought to you by Chris Crane Hyundai, Arkansas's number one Hyundai dealer, and Genesis of Conway, Arkansas's only Genesis dealer. Genesis of Conway, the future of luxury today. Now, here's Trey Biddy.
Well, Trey, I'm not sure where to begin. Do you want to begin with football, or would you like to begin with basketball?
Well, it is spring football, but I don't know if anybody's that interested in football right now when we've got what's going on with basketball and with Eric Musselman. This kind of started coming out. I mean, it's been talked about a little bit. Obviously, we've mentioned, you know, if the right West Coast job opened up, then that would be a possibility for Musselman. Didn't put a whole lot of credence in. The other jobs that people were talking about, Paul and Louisville and SMU, but when the when the USC job came open, that was one that definitely piqued our interest, just because what I've always been told, you know, that would be a job that he might be interested in. All the stuff with Hunter Yurecek, which we didn't even talk about on the radio yesterday. I think that happened like right before I came on with his interview with One Star Recruits, and you know, that left a little bit of like, what is happening? What is going on here?
Mm-hmm.
You know, following the, you know, him issuing the must bus tweet video last week also. And so there's definitely a lot of head scratching. Either Hunter Yurecek has lost his marbles, or he's he knows exactly what he's doing. I don't know if there's any in between, but the report, obviously, and we were able to confirm that you know, he's quote unquote interviewing for the USC job is true. And I mean, at this point, like, if you're a sitting Power 5 head coach with two Elite Eights and a Sweet 16 under your belt in the last, you know, 4 years, are you really interviewing for a job? Or are you just
– No.
Is
no.
that just – yeah.
He's just finding
what
out
is coaching search 101? We've done a lot of coaching searches on this show.
Yeah.
Coaching search 101 is you – nobody is offered the job and nobody accepts a job until both are done. So you either – nobody's offered the job until
right.
somebody accepts his job. Nobody accepts a job until it's offered. And nobody at, you know, a sitting Power 5 head coach, you know, at a school like Arkansas just goes off and interviews or
no.
gets on a flight to go interview. No. And what you check out the facilities and stuff like that. That just doesn't
no.
happen.
He'd be,
you know,
finished.
The only...
He's finished where he is. There's no way he can come back.
Yeah. Yep. So the Brandon Marcello reminded me that tomorrow is actually the anniversary, though, of Dana Altman backing out at Arkansas.
Wow.
So
good gracious.
There is stuff like that. Yeah, yeah. So, but, yeah, I mean, I'll say this about Musselman and the job, everything that's going on is when he took the job at Arkansas, it was a good job with great potential. Because we know where Arkansas basketball has been. We know what the fans think of Arkansas basketball. We know they'll show up just on hope a lot of times. And not a lot of other schools can do what Arkansas can do as far as packing that arena and stuff. Musselman did take this job and put Arkansas back on the map to where, if it does come to the point, which it looks like it's going to, where a hire is going to need be – need to be made, they ought to be able to get a pretty high-profile guy. I think this is the best job opening in college basketball, if it becomes open. You know, Michigan, Louisville are out there too, but I just think that this is – it's a great job. Musselman was making $4.2 million a year here, top 12 money in the country. And, yeah, you show – I mean, we talk about football talent in the state, but basketball talent, this state produces big-time basketball talent per capita. And, you know, there's potential there for NIL. They still have some work to do with Arkansas Edge in terms of getting that right. But, man, if they could get Arkansas Edge up to, like, matching what the Hunts do for basketball, then they'll be in great shape. And you got to think that people would step up also in the midst of a coaching change. You know, people that have the funds to do so to and that care about Arkansas basketball to, you know, to step up and make sure that the coach, whoever they're courting, knows that, hey, the funds are going to be there for NIL, because that's what so much of it comes down to. So this is Arkansas basketball is a great job if there's a vacancy.
I would think vacancy. Razorback fans will watch to see what Musselman says when he's introduced as USC coach. And if he mentions NIL potential, Razorback fans who have hesitated might jump in and help NIL here, because they may think, you know, really? Well, I think we can do just as good. That's what I think.
Well,
don't
Arkansas
you?
Can do is good. You know, the different, like, we point to, like, the Grove Collective and things that they're doing at Ole Miss. If Ole Miss can do that, Arkansas can. The thing with Arkansas is they have to be more proactive. Ole Miss, in a lot of ways, I think, are reacting to having success, especially in football. But you know, and speaking of Ole Miss, like, Chris Beard's been a name that's definitely been mentioned, like, what Arkansas.
But didn't he just
after,
recently
you know?
Sign an extension?
He recently agreed.
Oh, he agreed.
I've not seen anything about him signing.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, so there's that. But there are people who have told me for months that Chris Beard would be interested in the job at Arkansas if it became open. And we know that he was also a guy that was talked about a whole lot, you know, back when the job came open before Musselman was hired, when he was making that run to the through the NCAA tournament all the way to the championship game with Texas Tech. So, I mean, he would be, like, that would be an out of the park. Like, if he ended up getting it, that would be like, okay, well, Juracek knew what he was doing the whole time. It would be that kind of situation.
All right, let's talk with Hack. Hack, good afternoon. You got a question or comment for Trey?
Yeah. Trey, hold on to this one. I got a big one for you.
All right,
Rick, I got to give you all kinds of props. There is no way a coach is going to go anywhere for an interview. I'll go back to right when Nolan got fired. Tommy Boyd had a coach named Bill Self out of Illinois who said he would take the Arkansas job.
Mm-hmm.
And John White said, that's great, but you got to come and interview. And Bill Self said, no, do you see my credentials? My interview is saying yes. That's my interview. Mm-hmm. And that's Exhibit A. Going a little bit forward, this is where I'm getting to you, Trey. A few years ago, probably about 6 or 7 years ago, I met this gentleman, and he was telling me he was a manager for the Texas basketball team, 1990. I was a manager for the Razorback basketball team, 1990. We played Texas in the regional final, and the winner got to go to Denver.
Mm-hmm.
This gentleman told me back then he knew there was only a handful of schools that truly loved basketball. He said, you know, obviously Kentucky, Duke, you get that, North Carolina. And he had a couple schools. He said, Arkansas is one of those schools. They consider themselves a football state. And in the SEC, said they're probably about the 7th or 8th best program, honestly. He said, they're not the 7th or 8th best basketball. He goes, there's Kentucky, and then there's, he would say, Arkansas and Florida were kind of compatible because Florida won back-to-back natties. But he said, overall, Arkansas will get 15,000 to 20,000 even when Arkansas's team's, you know, good but not great. He said, and he knew back then that you couldn't get a ticket to Barnhill. You know, you want to put your name on a waiting list and hope, you know, someone, you know, in the next 20 years you get it. This gentleman's name was Chris Beard. And no I said, kidding. Chris Beard, would no you kidding. Ever take the Arkansas job? And he said, I would do it in a New York minute. He said, this is one of those schools. And you can look it up. Chris Beard was a manager for the Texas team in 1990.
No kidding.
Fast forward, people forget. And Dana Altman was a coach here one day. Chris Beard took the UNLV job, and about 2 weeks later left for Texas Tech. So, yes, he did commit to an extension. They didn't really bump up his pay, but it's more like we're extending it 3 more years for recruiting reasons. So that's one thing. We can offer $4.5-5 million if we have to. I mean, if you're going to go for a big time coach, and I think he's checked all the boxes. You guys were talking about earlier, he was one of the big choices we wanted originally. The problem was he just kept winning. He was supposed to get knocked out week one, and then he went to Sweet 16 and won again. And he went all the way to the national championship game. And we decided we couldn't wait, and I understand because, someone's got to get out there and recruit. And another thing Rick has been saying, and I never understood this, how come as soon as we got beat the day after the SEC tournament, all the way through, including today, Musselman has not said anything at all about Arkansas, his plans, his family. John Calipari got beat. And everybody in Kentucky was upset. He came out the very next day and said, hey, I'm going to be the coach next year. I've already got some recruits coming, and I'm already going to start changing some of the way I do recruiting. He came right out in front the next day, wanted everybody to know if he wasn't the coach, he was going to get fired. It wasn't on him. He squashed every rumor. So, Trey, obviously I think Chris Beard would be the best possible coach we could get.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, Ole Miss, the fact is Lane Kiffin makes $9 million a year. They are committed 120% for football. Don't doubt about it. We're never going to pay a football coach $9 million. And I get that, but I think we can go all in on basketball and say, hey, this is something we can actually win a national championship. And the way things are in modern-day basketball, I know you got to have new kids every year, but you can't – I don't personally think you can have 10 new kids every year. You still got to have some players coming up, playing a role. Hell, last year San Diego State played in the national championship game. Mm-hmm. And they had a whole 6-7 seniors. Now, were those guys McDonald's All-Americans? No, but they played the college role in another team. Florida Atlantic got there.
Well, you've made some very good points.
I think you've got to have them mixed.
Yeah, you've made some very good points, and let's let Trey respond to that. But I also in basketball today, I think about when Stan Heath replaced Nolan Richardson. It wasn't good. Nolan's best recruit left, his best player left, and you couldn't replace players then like you can now. Whoever the new coach is, will be able to build faster than previous coaches could do.
Yeah. I mean, Beard built pretty fast at Ole Miss, too.
Sure did. Yeah.
You know, if Arkansas was I don't know what to add to a lot of those points that he made. I love the – I knew he was talking about Chris Beard right when he got started about the GA in the 90s at Texas. If Arkansas had a coach that, won 29 games over 3 years, they might get up there. I think Kiffin's at 8.7. million, something like that. So maybe they would get there if they had that kind of success on the football field. I don't know what else to add. I've had people, for a couple of months say Chris Beard would be interested if the job, became open. And I'm not really sure what else to add. He made a lot of great points, though, and some interesting conversation.
Well, Hunter Yurecek would win a lot of points if, after Musselman's announced tomorrow at USC, he announces the new coach at Arkansas either Thursday or Friday.
It's a much better job than when Musselman took over.
Yes, right.
Especially if he could keep the four remaining players that are intact right now.
Keep two of them and get Leighton Blocker to come back.
Yeah, what about your freshmen, your recruits?
Yeah, those two guys, you never know. You got to see what you can do to keep them, but if they want to leave, you got to let them go.
Yep.
All right, Trey, let's shift gears real quick to football. Yep. I realize that some may want to know what Bobby Petrino had to say today.
Yeah, it was good talking to Bobby Petrino again, the second time we've been able to talk to him since he's been hired. And, you know, just asked him a little bit about Taylen Green and that process. I thought it was real funny when, you know, he said he had all those energetic, you know, young coaches with him at Missouri State. And they're like, they show him, you know, video of Taylen Green, like, we can get this guy. And Bobby's like, no, we're not going to get that. He's too good. He's too tall, you know, all this stuff. But, you know, we talked to Taylen about just how the process unfolded and how quick Arkansas got in touch with him. And Petrino says he really liked how, you know, he's able to explain stuff to him about different plays and stuff. And he could see Taylen envisioning it and picturing it in his head. And that's something that he always looks for in a quarterback. So I thought that was cool to hear that story. Petrino usually speaks very plainly, obviously, and I thought he did when talking about the different personnel, how much he likes Tyrone Brodin and Andrew Armstrong, their ability to go inside and outside, and what he envisions for Isaiah Satania. There was some talk about Joe Adams, Jarius Wright, you know, maybe in that mold of a player. That would certainly be entertaining. And, you know, I asked him, too, just because I remember back in 2008, the offense didn't just hit the ground running, you know, but they also really relied on a lot of young players. It was, you know, back in that age, you started with a group of young players and you built them up and you hope you made a run, you know, that third, fourth year or something like that. Maybe you had a couple of good years and a couple of years where you were trying to build things up. And Arkansas did that with so many young players. But then now, I mean, it's just there's so many more old players on this roster. I mean, you've got – they may not have done it here, but you've got a highly experienced left tackle, a highly experienced running back, a highly experienced quarterback, you know, offensive linemen who are all have starts under their belts, and except for Blackstock, I guess. And I don't know – I mean, Nichols just a couple, but – you, overall, you're pretty experienced on offense, and, you know, so I was asking him, like, is it going to be quicker? You know, they almost lost to Western Carolina, Louisiana, Monroe. I mean, that first year coming out of the gate, they got stomped by Texas and Florida and I believe Alabama also, just kind of like one after another, and then they finally started picking things up and putting it together, and obviously the rest is history, but hopefully they'll be able to start faster this year because they're going to have to because you have Stillwater in week two, you have Auburn in week four early in the season. So, you know, so, but yeah, it was good talking. Now today you learn a lot from a scrimmage, obviously, but also from the first practice after a scrimmage. A lot of times there's some shakeup with personnel and, you know, maybe they start installing some new things. We did see some new installs. They're running, you know, they had an I form out there today. We haven't seen that in a while where they, you know, they had Dominic Johnson as the fullback. They had Maddox Lassiter, who's the walk-on tight end from Warren. He was lined up at fullback today. They were doing some three tight end stuff, 13 personnel, some 22 personnel with two tight ends and two running backs. So they were working on some more jumbo stuff, just kind of for situational stuff that they weren't able to use in the scrimmage. Like, you know, you're backed up to your own 2 yard line. You know, you want to get, you know, just kind of falling forward and you need some bigger personnel for that. And, you know, there were some other situations, goal line, where they were implementing some of that stuff. And then on the defensive side of the ball, they were working some 4-3. We've seen them do the mint front. I don't remember if they did a whole lot of mint front today. Well, I know that they had Kavion Henderson lined up as the buck with the third team, but a lot of 4-3 and, you know, their 4-2-5 base defense. But injury-wise, let me check my injury report real quick. Andrew Armstrong was out there and doing stuff in individual, but he wasn't full go. You still got Tyrus Washington in green. Let me see here. I've got it written down. The full report for injuries. Let's see. Andreas Paske, Puska was full go today. He's got a thumb issue. Bryce Stevens was out, and Jaden Wilson was still out. And I mentioned Armstrong. Zuri Madison's obviously out. So just a few injuries here and there, but didn't look like anything real major coming out of that scrimmage. I don't recall anybody new that was missing, and, you know, most of those guys were already banged up before the scrimmage.
Trey, real quick before we run out of time, I love the fact that he seemed so encouraged by the offensive line. He said,
yeah,
looks like we've got eight right now we feel like we can count on.
Yes. I still want to see what's out there in the transfer portal, but it's definitely good to hear from Petrino because he doesn't really sugarcoat.
There you go. All right, Trey, we will talk to you tomorrow. Folks, we are out of time. Coming up next, Arkansas Razorback Baseball. For Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater. Buzz Animal Cruelty, spay and neuter your pet. So long, everybody.
Join the Zone each Monday for Game Balls and Jockstraps. Brought to you by A. Caddy's Touch Landscaping. Find out who made the best, average, and worst headlines in sports and entertainment each Monday as Justin Akery and Wes Moore give you their Game Balls and Jockstraps on the Zone from 10 to 1. It's all brought to you by A. Caddy's Touch Landscaping, 501-794-2770. Call today to get your landscape updated to a whole new level and be listening for Game Balls and Jockstraps only on 103.7 The Buzz.
Did you know you can have high cholesterol without any symptoms? High LDL or bad cholesterol can have a big impact on your cardiovascular health, increasing your risk of a heart attack or stroke. Reduce your risk by knowing your LDL cholesterol level and working with your doctor on a treatment plan. Lowering your LDL cholesterol today can help you enjoy a healthier tomorrow. Visit the American Heart Association at heart.org/LDL to learn why lower is better.
Hey, everything okay?
Yes, I'm fine.
Honey. Hey, I'm here for you. Tell me about school today.
When kids can't find the right words, music can help them sound it out. Talk to the kids in your life about their emotional well-being. Find tools and resources at soundedouttogether.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and Pivotal Ventures.
What's up, everyone? It's Christian Weaver for The Zone. Tomorrow we'll have Joe Klein in studio to discuss the March Madness, men's and women's. Hagen Smith will come on thanks to Stifel Financial in the first hour. In the second hour, Kevin Kelly will join us thanks to Little Rock Athletic Club. Andy Anacorti will come on for the Hat Club Crawfish event. It's all that and much more Wednesday in The Zone, where sports and entertainment come crashing together.